Hey up, happy Saturday. It's Halloween. Got my black talons. I am on my second day of taking my meds. I have to take 3 a day, but it's the lowest dose. I'm feeling slightly better. I don't know whether that's the placebo effect. I don't know whether that's actually fact. I am hungry. It's 2:20. I haven't got out of bed yet. I'm gonna have some food. I'm gonna have one of those pots that I got at Sainsbury's 2 days ago. And today might finally be the day. Yeah, I can't really be bothered. It's really grim today and grey and it's dark. Oh, my battery's low. Yeah, with the meds, I don't know if I said this yesterday. She told me that you can get two types of anti-anxiety meds. You can get the type that sort out if you have a low mood and anxiety, like antidepressants, or you can get ones that just do the anxiety, and they can be taken in two different ways, either when you know you're gonna have a different difficult day or a lower dose more regularly. So that's the one, they're the ones I got. I didn't get the mood affecting ones. Yeah, just got the anxiety affecting ones. Let's eat, I'm hungry. Hello. This must be so easy to make. I need to actually do some proper cooking. It doesn't look that appetizing, doesn't it? This is the creamy coconut cauliflower sambar. So let's give it a taste. Yes, I'm eating in bed because yes, it's that type of day. Crunchy. It's okay, tastes a bit acidic. I think because I very rarely eat ready meal kind of things, I think it is nice. The flavors are nice. It's a bit spicy. It's a bit different things. I just know I could make it so much better myself. I feel like it needs coconut milk in it. Yeah, needs a bit of creaminess, I think. It's a bit too zesty, a bit too processed. So I've come out for a walk because my anxiety took a turn. And in a video, a couple of videos ago, I mentioned that when I was walking, there was a man polishing his canoe. Wait, let me say that properly. Polishing his canoe. And a few of you thought I was joking, so I'm going to show you this canoe. It's a different canoe. The canoe he had last time was wooden. Maybe he sold it. Maybe that was why he was polishing it. It feels really good to be out, even though I'm a bit chilly. I did just put on this jumper, which has soy sauce down it that I spilled yesterday. Who cares? And it was fresh on yesterday as well, annoyed. But beautiful colours, lovely sky, gorgeous walk. Bagel, anyone? This house definitely wins Halloween. At the door. It looks so cool. A black cat on Halloween. Hello. Come here. Yay. Bye. Come on. Oh, hello. I've been out walking now for a fair while. It's getting dark a little bit. And yeah, it's blown away the cobwebs. Halloween pun. Oh, that house looks nice. I can still feel it pulsating away. But yeah, feel better for having a walk. I'm proper excited because this has come. It's a little parcel. It's two things I bought on Depop. Depop is like a secondhand people selling clothes. Sometimes they're new, sometimes they're not. And because I live in a shared house, you never know if your parcel is going to be taken in or not. Obviously, I'm normally in, but on the off chance, I was obviously out. So here we go. Let's give it an open. Yeah, I'm never going to be able to do that with one hand. Ooh! So ages ago, my cousin stole my scarf that I lent him. Really annoying, but it's just what happened. So I bought a lovely new dog tooth scarf. This is very nice. New dog tooth scarf. And she was doing free postage if you bought two things. So I bought this bum bag because I'm 12 years old and it's brand new. I thought, it's new from New Look. I thought it might be cool to accessorise a dark outfit with. Obviously not to be worn together, but I've just finished last week's vlog and now it's rendering. So it's gonna be up tomorrow. And it's so much better than like rushing myself like 10 minutes before I normally upload. Oh my God, can't even tell you. Oh no, there's my laptop. Oh, I put it on its back because the fan's too noisy. Anyway, I was just sitting on my bed contemplating what to do with my life. And this like little song came into my head and it only was like five notes. It went, oh, that was out of tune. Terrible. That was so out of tune. And may all your Christmases be white. What's your favourite Christmas song? Comment below. That's probably one of mine. Roads are terrible! I'm in my car. I'm in my mum's car. I'm in my car. Obviously I'm going out. I'm going to my bubble friend. My friend who's in my bubble's house. Because Boris Johnson right now is doing an announcement that could, actually I think he's already done it, that could lay down a lockdown from Monday, so 2 days time. And if that happens, I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm all for it, because whatever gets the numbers down, because I'm happy to stay inside if people stay safe. Simple as that. Come on, guy. You know, I'm at the point now in the year where you know, there's no getting it back. It's Halloween today. There's not much of the year left. Also, how is it Halloween today? Surely it's May. I just don't get it. Yeah, so I'm happy. So many people are annoyed. So many people are just shut up and stay inside, basically. Like, there's nothing to, you know, life will start back when things are over. And if people are just respectful and compliant, it will be over so much quicker. And yeah, that's my little views on it. So I kind of had to force myself out tonight. It's funny because I made plans and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna have a shower, put my makeup on, actually feel like a normal person. And then just before I was about to go out, I was like, oh, I don't want to go, let's cancel. But I kind of not forced myself, because that makes, this is the thing, it's not like I don't want to go out. I do want to go out, I do want to see my friend, but sometimes anxiety, if you have anxiety, you'll know what I'm talking about, it just takes over. I just got a comment from one of you lot. I can't remember who said it, so apologies. She said, I love your videos because you never know what's going to come next. I mean, I don't know. It's always a surprise for me. And even when I film stuff, I edit it and I'm like, oh yeah. I like laugh along with, because I think I'm hilarious. Oh, this bit doesn't have any lights on the road, so it's going to go dark. Good morning, happy Sunday. It's 20 to midday, 20 to 12, and I've just barely woken up. So good. Single people sometimes get a bad rap for not having kids and not being married and not doing this, but when you can wake up whenever you want to wake up and have no one to answer to, winner today. I'm a winner. Good morning. So Boris Johnson announced a second lockdown last night, a month-long lockdown from midnight on the 4th of November until the 2nd of December. So it feels quite manageable that it's only a month. As I said last night, I'm happy to do it. And one of the things that wasn't the same as last time was that support bubbles are still okay. So my friend who I'm in a support bubble with, I can still see her. That would make it a lot more manageable, because pretty much that's all I've been doing anyway. I haven't been going out, I haven't been going to the pub, I've been to brunch a few times, because you know, brunch. But yeah, the only thing I'm gonna miss is the gym, but needs must. I'm gonna have a decaf coffee now. I need to do the washing up. Shock, freaking horror. And is it too much to dye my hair? It's too much. I feel a bit flat today, but that's because of the weather. One of my leaves has fallen off. Let's go and explore.
Yeah.
But I'd rather the leaves fall off. I mean, it's growing so much, it's insane. It had a big leaf here that had gone yellow, and since it fell off, these ones here, this one especially, has just like shot up. Obviously because it's not trying to put in growth into a dead leaf. But I love my little IKEA. I got this from IKEA ages ago. Getting my vitamin C in. My alarm's going off. Why is my alarm going off? If that triggers anyone, you know what it's like when you hear your alarm and it's not, oh. You know when you hear your alarm and it's not your time to get up, you're like, ah. Guess what time it is? Tupperware breakfast time. It's Tupperware breakfast time, Tupperware breakfast time, Tupperware breakfast time, yeah. Did I show you my makeup earlier? I can't remember. I've just filmed a big gay Q&A. And oh my God, it's like nearly dark now. It was quite a lot of TMI actually. Just putting away my tripod. Well actually, this tripod here. So when I was young, when I was four, I think I was four, my brother was about two. Mum and dad were struggling for money. So I think my dad had two, no, I think my dad was thinking of having a second job, but he didn't. But my mum was a stay-at-home mum. So she, always an entrepreneur, my mum. She started a video business where she would go and video people's birthday parties and, you know, bar mitzvahs and funerals. No, probably not funerals. But she bought a video camera because she had one for us, for the kids. And she was like, hey, I'm going to go and video people's parties and make tapes and actual VHS tapes and sell them. And she did so much amazing stuff with that. And that was her tripod that she used to use. And I think that's why I am so at home being on camera, because I've always had it. I've always had it stuck in my face and being like, how are you? What's, you know, having little interviews and having it around as I grew up. So thanks to mum, obviously thanks to mum I've been born, but thanks to mum I'm here sharing this with you. Thanks mum. I've just done the washing up, hence the sweat, and I'm eating a really random dinner, but it's so nice. It's the leftover rice from last week, because it's rice, it's fine. Spinach, a vegan chicken burger, cut up into pieces, smothered in sweet chili sauce. It's one of those meals that I'm so hungry, I'm just scoffing it for no real reason. And uploading my video, and now I'm gonna edit the video I just filmed, even though it's so long, it's gonna take me ages. Washing up done. It's dinner time, even though it feels like I've just eaten. I'm hungry again. And I'm gonna make a bolognese. So exciting food for the first time in ages. So let me show you what's gonna go in it. It's gonna be a pretty boring bolognese, but we're gonna have garlic, onion, tomatoes, mushrooms. I don't like carrot in my bolognese. Or celery, I feel like it's not right. Gonna do this meat, mince. Gonna do a bit of nutritional yeast and some spinach. Oh yeah, and pasta with it as well, obviously. Here it is. It looks slightly like dog food, but I mean, it made loads. Here's mine. I'm gonna put a bit of this on it. Oh, I can't do it with my left hand. Oh, that looks like a heart. Ah. Yum. Let's do a taste test. Eating this over my white bed sheet is not the best idea. I added some extra things. I added oregano, garlic powder, tomato puree. Yum. Let's try the mince on its own. I like that. Not bad. I mean, it's not meat, but it's not bad. It's too hot. It's too hot. I'm gonna let it cool down for at least 2 minutes. I'm just hungry. Oh, I just realized it's Sunday night. So, oh, it's makeup. I didn't take all my makeup off properly. And my eyes really watered when I cut up the onions. Good morning. I've literally just woken up like this, so this is interesting. Happy Monday. Oh, it's like unearthing a troll. Happy Monday.
Happy Monday.
Happy Monday. Happy Monday. No, wait. Happy Monday. You can't hear it, but upstairs it's playing music. It's 8 a.m. like. But you know what time it is, really? Is my bum in the mirror? No. Guess what time it is, really? Let's guess the weather. 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 Oh, hello. Oh, nearly a crash. With the sound of music. Right, it's a mixed bag. Just like this hairstyle. It's a mixed bag. There's some fast moving clouds. It's windy. It was so windy last night. It was great. I just love any extreme weather. Well, no, I love it when I'm listening to it from the safety of my own home. I would not have been happy to be outside. But let me show you the clouds just to bring you in on this experience together. There. I can see little bits of blue sky. And yeah, so who knows what might happen. Yeah, you can all wait with bated breath. My kitchen is in a cupboard. And guess what is in the kitchen in a cupboard? Lots of washing up? No. No. Oh my God. My alarm. Let me take my tablets and then I'll continue with what I was telling you. So if you missed last week, I started taking medication for my anxiety. I was up and down about it for a long time because I've never been pro-medication. I've always thought, oh, you can, you know, meditate the anxiety away. You can do this to get it away. You can, you know, and so many people can. And if you're one of those people, then amazing. But I just feel like at this time in my life, it was a daily struggle. I was constantly feeling like so highly strung and just ready to like explode that I just couldn't handle it anymore. So I don't consider medication to be a long-term thing for me. But I mean, we're in a freaking pandemic, so I'm gonna give myself a little grace and take it. I feel like it's working so far. This is my fourth day of taking it. And the other tablet I'm taking is for my stomach because I've had tummy issues. But ironically, I think that stomach issues are caused by the anxiety, so. Anyway, last night, washing up done. Oh. Kitchen in a cupboard, kitchen in a cupboard, kitchen in a cupboard. Yeah. Love you. My neighbours at his window. They were roommates. She's doing. Oh my God, I hope she doesn't hurt herself. They're doing exercises again. Is it? Yeah, it's been a week, hasn't it? Hello, it's me. I've been watching you do your workout, and I think you're really great. It's so early and you should be in bed, but I'm proud of you. So windy. Yay! I couldn't cope with my hair anymore. So I had to restrain it. Yeah, what a gorgeous morning. It's so windy. I love it. Gorgeous. I made it back just in... Sorry, I've just had loads of water. I made it back just in time because it's just started raining. So I'm feeling smug as well as post-walk smugness, escaped the rain smugness, all round smugness. Now I need food because I should have eaten a while ago. Next door are having new windows. I think they must be having new windows out the back because Annie and James, might be Annie and James, getting new windows. I do need to have a tidy up today because I've just moved all of the clothes that were on the sofa onto the bed, which obviously, oh, by the way, if you ever see this pillow and think, what's going on? I have a pillow on it that says, be relaxed. When I was in Cyprus, my Cyprus peeps, Gemma, Anita, you would know Jumbo. There's a massive shop in Paphos called Jumbo, which is basically like Poundland on like an IKEA size level. It's amazing, horrifying and exhausting all in one, and amazing all in one go. And there was this pillow there a couple of years ago that was like, it looked like a radio. It was like a similar shape to that. And it just said, be relaxed on it. And I just thought, I know I shouldn't take the Mickey out of, you know, Cypriots trying to write English because I could not write a word of Cypriot. I could speak a couple of words, but I can't write anything. So it was just funny. So me and Mum always used to say, be relaxed. And she tried to get this pillow for me from a few different people that we know in Cyprus. And it just, they stopped selling it or whatever. So for my birthday last year, Mum customised me a be relaxed pillow. If ever you're stressed, be relaxed. So that's that little snippet for Monday morning. I need some food. What do I fancy? Cereal. I fancy something cold because I'm hot. I don't fancy porridge. That's one of the things I do. I was thinking to do a video of like a day in a life. I know I do weekly vlogs, but like a day in a life of the choices and the mindsets. Of the choices and the mindsets I have to living. I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm not like this all the time. And I'm not like, listen to me because I'm the oracle. Partly. My mindsets and my thought processes and feelings around, wait, would you like to see a video about living intuitively? Now, as I said, don't do it all the time. I'm just on a roll at the moment. So yeah, eating intuitively, moving intuitively, living intuitively. And I just thought it'd be quite cool to do a day in a life to say, before I would have got up and looked in the mirror and thought, I hate this, I hate that, I hate this, but now I do this. See what I'm getting there? See where I finally got there with that? Right, food time. Oh, this is how lazy I am. I just said, oh, because my bowl is at the bottom of that. How freaking lazy. I might have a decaf coffee as well to celebrate. Just, it's Monday, isn't it? Oh, have I broken a nail? No. I nearly broke a nail then. Well, I nearly broke my face, but I nearly broke a nail as well. Oh God. Palaver. Bit of that. Bit of this random muesli that I've got in here. It's whole grain muesli from Lidl. Oh, I've run out of pomegranate. Seed mix. Is this good ASMR? Ta-da! You guys remember my best friend Charlie, who was here the other week, fell in love with my bin pillow, and told a story about me being in a bush. If you know, you know. Anyway, she watches my videos. She's one of my rare friends, amazing friends, that actually puts up with me for 40 minutes on top of being my friend in real life. And she just, so in a video, I think a couple of weeks ago, I said that I can sometimes be cruel. This was the voice note she just sent me.
Sometimes I can be a bit cruel. Oh, you are savage. Savage.
I'm a savage. 11:11.
To get connected to the officer of HMRC. If in case you don't press 1 and your call is not connected to us, then the warrant will be issued under your name straight away and you will get arrested shortly.
I love these fake HMRC calls. It's hilarious. You will be arrested shortly. Also, I mean, I hope it's fake. I've just noticed that the for sale to let sign opposite has gone. Walk out the door. Don't turn around now. You're not welcome anymore. So we're going to have some new neighbours soon. Some new spying bait. That's not the right word. Quick and easy leftover lunch. It's a spiralised courgette, coriander, a bit of spiralised carrot, and that tofu that I bought last week. That shouldn't have been eaten. That should have been eaten by now, but... And coriander, did I say that? Mmm, yum. Oh, it's also got soy sauce in it. For a bit of flavour. I've got a snack. It's the seeded hummus from Sainsbury's. Got sesame, sunflower, pumpkin, and poppy seeds in it. Mm. I'm so excited about this. Mmm. Oh, this is gonna be dangerous. Look at that, you can see all the seeds in it. Oh, it's so nice. Today is just one of those days where I am hungry. My period's due in 4 days, so. Mmm. Because of my meds, I would normally have like massive anxiety at this time because that's what I get with PMS, but I don't really have that today, so it's just the hunger. This is peanut butter and banana on seeded toast with a bit of salt on top. Mmm. Do you want me to tell you something that's so TMI? I never thought I'd say something like this on the vlog. I don't know if it was that blimmin' fake mince last night or what, but I have been trumping all day. All day. Yeah, I say the words Trump for farts. That was the way we were brought up. We never said fart. We would either say Trump or blow off. I've just blown off, or did you just blow off? We would never say, did you fart? It just wasn't in our family's vocab. So yeah, I've been trumping all day, which is not attractive in the slightest. I just thought I'd share that with you because real life, yeah. Home from Aqua. I've semi-dried my hair. Can't be bothered to fully dry my hair. And just putting my dinner on. I'm having a rerun of last night's dinner, the bolognese and some pasta. I'm also gonna do some spiralized courgette because I've got some left over and they need to be eaten. I'm feeling really drained tonight. Really drained. I had a bit of a weird, in the class, I kind of had like a, not an out of body experience. I kind of just felt like it wasn't, I wasn't really there. I don't know if that was because tonight was the last of that aqua class until we got into lockdown. Anyway, my eyes look quite green tonight, don't they? Might be because my face is red. So let's get this pasta on. I know what will cheer me up. Siri, please play Christmas hits on Spotify. Oh.
385 quarters, now we're going
to... I was just watching a video on how much this guy makes from his vending machines. Because what else would I want to do to use my time wisely? The one morning I wake up early, so it's 7:26. I saw this video a little while ago that said if you wake up naturally in the morning or if you set an alarm, you should get up. You shouldn't snooze, you should get up because you sleep in sleep cycles that last about 90 minutes. So if you snooze and go back to sleep, you're always going to be more tired when you wake up again. Who knows if that's true? But this morning when I woke up naturally, I was like, I should probably... Sorry, my laptop's whistling away. I should probably get up. So I've got my hot ginger water. I haven't taken my tablet today, so I need to do that actually. Yeah, feeling a bit dazed this morning, feeling tired. I want to take this moment to say, I just love plants. I just love plants so much. Like, especially in a little room like this, they really enhance my living here. I just love... I'm kind of getting used to some of my plants now because I'm a plant novice. This one here is the one that I grew from like three cuttings from my brother. And I was so proud that it grew so quickly and it looked so good. And I sent a picture to him and he was like, yeah, it's great to have an easy plant to grow, isn't it? I was like, what are you saying? I'm taking praise for that one. And obviously it does depend on watering and it does depend on placement and it does depend on so many things and love, and obviously it loves my singing. That's what it is, my babies. So I am actually sitting here editing. You know, one weird thing that, I don't know if this is weird, but I love it when you put a jumper on for like the second day or something and it smells like your fragrance because you sprayed it on the day before, but it's not as fresh. It's like a bit musky, or it's a bit diluted, but it still smells really nice. Is that weird? I've been like sniffing myself today because I smell like aftershave. Better than beef. I smell like beef. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Just painted my nails red because it's the 3rd of November, therefore Christmas. This colour is Essie in the colour Fishnet Stockings. They're still putting in those windows outside next door, so they're banging around like no one's business today. Look at this picture. Mummy there. Aged 26. See, how old are you here? Mum aged 26. She said she made this dress because my mum used to do seamstressing. Guess who just got sent a nude on Instagram? It was me, just in case you didn't get that. Yeah, I just got sent a nude. It wasn't a dick, it was a bum. Like a whole face. Like, just imagine I was laying on the bed and I took a picture like this. So like back and bum and like feet were up. It was very limber. Yeah, very thick eyebrows. Also, full face in it. That's quite brave. I once got sent a dick pic on Instagram. I mean, it happens very rarely, like once a year maybe. And this is not my request for more because... disgusting. And yeah, this guy sent me his dick pic and I said, please tell me that this is a dried up chipolata and not your disgusting penis. And then he sent me another one and I was like, no, it's definitely your disgusting penis. And did I even respond to that? I can't remember, but yeah, it was disgusting. It looked crusty. Ain't got no time for that. No thanks. Sarah Powell is...
Morning, everyone. I'm in the office. So, stealth 11s is, but wait, I have a mince pie, my first of the year. Joanna, you've done extremely well there. I think I talked about...
This Sarah Powell, she's just amazing. Everyone should go follow her. She's just sweetness and light. Lunch is fried eggs on toast with beans. But I've put the beans in the bowl because I don't like when the beans make the bread go soggy. So, yum. And I've also got a bib on because I will spill it down myself. Told you. Lunch finished. Crisis avoided. And I want to say thank you to Sarah King in the comments. Is this the way to Amarillo? Every night I've been hugging my bin pillow. It's true. I do kind of I use it like a pregnancy pillow, even though I'm not pregnant. So thank you, Sarah, for Is This the Way to Amarillo? Which is going to be in my head all day. And now I'm going to probably have comments being like, thanks, Sarah. It's annoying. Something like that. Please comment and tell Sarah off if that's you. Every night I've been hugging my bin pillow. Do you do this? Do you sing and then think, oh, that was really good? So you go into your phone, you then record what you sung and you play it back all excited, and then it's nothing like what you thought and it's terrible and you delete it and then go and hide in a cave. Do you do that? No? No, neither do I. It's...
that you know, and they ask you how you are, and you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.